Hey guys, Tegil here. This video is gonna be slightly more advanced than usual, and we're gonna cover a lot of stuff, so if you want to challenge yourself, you're good to go. If you want to learn only specific things, feel free to click on the time codes enabled below to skip through the parts that you're not interested in. And if you find it ever overwhelming at any point though, also feel free to move to the next lesson. It's gonna be much easier and equally super useful. Now, if you decide to stay anyway, you can sit back and relax because I will take you through step by step. First, let's start with how to say to need in Korean. For the verb to need, we say 필요해요. 필요해요. The first part, 필요, means a need or necessity, and 해요 here is used as a support verb to enable the noun 필요 to function as a verb. Now, one easy way to memorize it is this. First, just repeat 해요 twice, so it becomes 해요, 해요. Then imagine a situation where you get sick and you need a pill. So then come back and change the first syllable to 필. 필요해요. There you go. 필요해요. Or think of Dr. Phil. Who doesn't need Dr. Phil? Or at least I do. So take the PH from his name as an aspirated P. 필. Dr. Phil 필요해요. Dr. Phil 필요해요. Now let's have a look at some examples using this verb. 오트밀 필요해요. This means you need oatmeal. The word oatmeal comes first because verbs are normally always placed at the end of a sentence or a phrase in Korean. And keep this in mind throughout this video. Keep the verbs at the end. 오트밀 필요해요. Now I'm gonna get you to practice. How would you say you need, of course not you specifically, but you in general, need parsley? 파슬리 필요해요. 파슬리 필요해요. How about you need tomatoes? Here I'm gonna give you a tip. In Korean, you don't need to say 어 as in a tomato, the indefinitive article. Nor do you need to say tomatoes as in plural. Most of the time, you don't need to specify the quantity. And if we want to know, we're gonna ask. So all you have to say is 토마토. That's it. So how would you say you need a tomato or tomatoes? 토마토 필요해요. 토마토 필요해요. And of course, you can replace tomato with other words too, like 모니터 필요해요, 핸드백 필요해요, 배터리 필요해요, and so on. I'm gonna tell you how to say we in Korean so that you can say we need something. We in Korean is 우리. So put 우리 at the beginning of the sentence, keep the verb 필요해요 at the end, as I said before, and whatever you need in between. Now we know how to say we need something in Korean. So let's imagine a situation where you go grocery shopping with your family or your partner, and then you realize you've run out of chocolates at home. Chocolates in Korean is 초콜릿. So how'd you say we need chocolates in Korean? 우리 초콜릿 필요해요. 우리 초콜릿 필요해요. You also hear people say 초콜릿. 초콜릿. So you can also say 초콜릿 필요해요. 초콜릿 필요해요. Let's think of another situation. How about you need a specific ingredient for a dish that you are trying to cook? Say for example, spaghetti. Spaghetti. And you need basil for that. 바질. First, let's say we need basil. How would you say we need basil? 우리 바질 필요해요. 우리 바질 필요해요. Now let's say you need basil for the spaghetti. For this, we learned in lesson 6 how to use postpositional particles. There we learned a postposition 에, which meant a whole lot of things, among which in or for were included. I also mentioned that it's placed after the noun and added to the end. So to say for the spaghetti or in the spaghetti, you can say spaghetti first and add the particle 에 after. Spaghetti 에. Then the rest of the sentence as in the example before. 스파게티에 바질 필요해요. And finally, the full sentence with the subject we would be 우리 스파게티에 바질 필요해요. 우리 스파게티에 바질 필요해요. Now try yourself saying we need oregano for the spaghetti or we need oregano in the spaghetti. 우리 스파게티에 오레가노 필요해요. 우리 스파게티에 오레가노 필요해요. And you know, here, I'm going to tell you something really funny. There is a verb in Korean called 오래가다, which means that a state or a phenomenon stays long or lasts long. And believe it or not, as a matter of fact, 오래가노 is an actual variant of the verb 오래가다. And it's used in 경상도, in the southern part of South Korea, often as a rhetorical question. For example, if you ever hear, 왜 이렇게 오래가노? It means, why does it take so long like this? Or why does it last so long like this? 왜 이렇게 오래가노? So this oregano comes in handy to recall when you want to remember how to say something lasts long in Korean. And also notice that the Korean interrogative word 왜 kind of resembles the English word why. It's like why, 왜. That also helps, eh? Now, when the verb 오래가다 is conjugated to the present tense casual polite form, it becomes 오래가요. 오래가요. So, for example, if someone asks, 아이폰 배터리 오래가요? It means, does the iPhone battery last long? 아이폰 배터리 오래가요? Since we've been talking about herbs, I want to tell you something interesting about herbs too. For the word herb, we keep the H sound there. So, we never say obu. We say hobu. Now, having said that, for humor though, it's the contrary. We don't pronounce that H. So instead of saying humor, we say yumo. And if you want to say someone is humorous, first say yumorosu, and then our favorite magic verb, 해요. In this case, 해요 can mean to be. Yumorosu 해요. Yumorosu 해요. Now, there are a lot of English adjectives that we use in Korean, and I'll show you what they are and how to use them in the next video. A whole lot of them that you can add to your vocabulary instantly with really minimal effort, and yet you can start using them right away to expand what you can express in Korean. Now, going back to the word 허브, 허브 is interesting because it's also a homonym to the word hub, which is often used in economics as in 비즈니스 허브, or 빅데이터 허브, or 글로벌 R&D 허브. And also it's used in electronics as in USB 허브. Now let's go back to the supermarket situation. Let's imagine that you found something on sale. To say something is on sale, we say sale and our magic verb 해요. Sale 해요. Now let's say bananas are on sale. Banana, 세일해요. Banana, 세일해요. Now your turn. Let's say oranges are on sale. How would you say oranges are on sale?
오렌지, 세일해요. 오렌지, 세일해요.
And of course, you can replace orange with any other words there. So if computers are on sale,
컴퓨터, 세일해요.
Cameras are on sale.
카메라 세일해요.
If Louis Vuitton goes on sale,
Louis Vuitton 세일해요.
So feel free to be creative and keep on building with different words. Now let's learn how to say something is cheap in Korean. But I'm gonna tell you in advance, it's not 집해요. We never say 집해요. But instead, I'm gonna bring back the word sale, because it's kind of similar. Something is cheap, 싸요. So remember the word sale, like if something goes on sale, it gets cheaper. Something is cheap, 싸요. 싸요 in itself is like a verb. Its base form is 싸다. And by now, you may have noticed that all the verbs end in the same ending, 다, in Korean, which makes it very easy. Anyway, 싸요 is already in the present tense casual polite form, so to say something is cheap, all you need to do is to put that something at the beginning of a sentence as a subject. So let's say bananas are cheap.
바나나 싸요. 바나나 싸요.
Now as a practice, I suggest you say on your own, cherries are cheap.
체리 싸요. 체리 싸요.
When things are cheap, 사요, you may want to buy them. To say you buy, you say 사요. It's all related. 사요. So, sale, 사요, 사요. That's a cycle of life, isn't it? Sale 해요, 사요, 사요. Now, let's say you buy bananas. 바나나 사요. 바나나 사요. We've learned how to say we in Korean, 우리. So let's imagine saying we buy bananas.
우리 바나나 사요. 우리 바나나 사요.
Now, depending on the context and depending on how you say it, the same sentence can be a suggestion. So if it's like 우리 바나나 사요, then it means let's buy bananas. And if you raise the intonation at the end, it becomes a question.
바나나 사요?
Do we buy bananas? All in one form. Easy, right? Now, you may have to argue like, we must buy this, or we have got to buy that. Because the other person that went shopping with you does not agree with you. Does it happen to you guys? This happens a lot to me with my mom. Now, we've actually learned how to say to have to do something in lesson 4. And if you remember, our magic verb 해요 can also mean to have to, apart from its most common usage as to do. Now, to say to have to do something, what we did was to repeat 해요 twice. Then we changed the second syllable of the first 해요 to 야. So to have to do was 해야 해요. Now, to say to have to buy, we're gonna do something very similar. First, we put 사요, then place 해요 after, because the second 해요 means to have to, and change the ending of 사요 to 야. So finally, it becomes 사야 해요, and that means to have to buy. 사야 해요. So for practice, let's say we have to buy romaine lettuce. Now, the word for lettuce is 상추. So for romaine lettuce, we say 로메인 상추. Now, how would you say we must buy romaine lettuce?
우리 로메인 상추 사야 해요. 우리 로메인 상추 사야 해요.
Now here, for your information, the word romaine means Roman, as in from Rome. And if you read it as 로마인, that means a Roman person in Korean, as in someone from the Roman Empire. The word 인 is derived from a Chinese word that looks like this, which means a human or person. And this word 인 can be used as a suffix in the form of country name plus 인 to describe someone's nationality. I'll make another video focusing on this. So for now, just remember that 로마인 from the word 로마인 means a Roman person. Finally, we're gonna learn how to say made in, as in made in China, for example. For that, we use the word 산. It comes from a Chinese letter that looks like this, which means to produce. And we add this at the end of the country name. And unlike in English, the goods or products made from that country come after. So, for example, to say kiwis produced in New Zealand would be 뉴질랜드산 kiwi. 뉴질랜드산 kiwi. Like New Zealand produced kiwis. So when we say 산, word to word, it's not literally made in, but we still get the same idea. Now for practice, I'm going to have you say hemp seeds produced in Canada. Hemp seeds produced in Canada in Korean is
캐나다산 hemp seed. 캐나다산 hemp seed.
How about chia seeds from Paraguay? I said it deliberately like this. Chia seeds from Paraguay.
Paraguay산 chia seed. Paraguay산 chia seed.
For your information, the word chia from chia seed by itself means teeth in Korean. Okay? Chia means teeth. Let's say olive oil made in Spain. Olive oil made in Spain is
스페인산 올리브 오일. 스페인산 olive oil.
How about bananas produced in the Philippines? Now remember to change the F sound to P. We don't have the F sound in Korean. And also treat the Philippines as a singular, so without S at the end.
필리핀산 바나나. 필리핀산 바나나.
And of course, the products don't have to be just agricultural produce. So let's say a handbag made in France. Now once again, remember to change the F sound to P and also the R sound to something in between R and L. So a handbag made in France is
프랑스산 핸드백. 프랑스산 핸드백.
Alright, so we've covered everything for this video. Let's quickly wrap it up here. First of all, we've learned how to say you need something in Korean. The verb was 필요해요. We also learned using the word oregano how to memorize the verb 오래가요, which meant something lasts long. Then we learned how to say something was on sale using the word 세일 and again using the verb 해요. And from there, we learned how to say something is cheap. If you remember, things become cheap when they go on sale. 싸요. And when things are 싸요, you want to buy them. 싸요. 싸요. And if they disagree, you argue. We have to buy. Which was 사야 해요. 사야 해요. Lastly, we learned how to say where something was made in or produced in, which was country name plus 산, and then the product or goods. Alright, we've covered a lot in this video. Thank you for watching through to the end. I hope I made it feel easy enough, and more importantly, hope it was useful for you. In the next video, as I said before, we're gonna talk about English adjectives used in Korean and how to use them with the verb 해요. Once again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.